Secretary's International Organization for the Elimination of All Forms of Racial Discrimination.
Thank you, Mr. President. We welcome the report by the Expert Mechanism on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples and Repatriation, and specifically regarding intangible cultural heritage. In this regard, we remind the Council that states carry the primary responsibility for ensuring that Indigenous peoples are able to safely exercise their rights and that accountability is established for violations against Indigenous human rights defenders. These rights and remedies can only be realized if the serious issue of corporate impunity by transnational corporations, big businesses, and extractive industries is addressed. To this end, there is an urgent need for a UN-binding treaty to regulate TNCs and effective remedies for the victims. Furthermore, access to justice regarding ceremonial objects and human remains can only be realized when Indigenous judicial and legal systems are acknowledged and strengthened by governments and international bodies. We also recall that a key issue from previous MRIP sessions that was echoed by numerous participants was on language and, in particular, the translation of the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, national and domestic law, and international law to Indigenous languages. In order to increase, promote, and raise awareness of rights of Indigenous peoples, the language barriers and other related obstacles and challenges must be overcome in a collaborative manner with Indigenous communities. In this regard, we would like to ask the expert mechanism what steps are being taken to ensure a strengthened partnership, especially in these challenging moments. In conclusion, EFORD and Geneva International Center for Justice recommends increased promotion of Indigenous languages and the adoption of an internationally legally binding treaty to regulate TNCs. I thank you.